7 nozzle. Brake up on it just a bit. It does move slower going forward, but the reverse is still stupid fast. So I'm going to stay back from it just because this is the one that I tried to stop with my hand while it was reversing. That was a really stupid idea. I hurt my hand really bad. It's much better now. It's healed. So I'm just going to stay back while it's running. That's just a smart thing to do. I need to adjust the reverse mechanism to just pull it out of the stream a little bit more and I gotta see if I won't be so quick. When I got this at the dealer, it was probably about 3-4 years ago, somewhere around in there. It was, I ran it once and it locked up. It was, bearings locked up on it, and it had a leak in the base, and I had it rebuilt. Then I had a 1.18 nozzle on it, which I reduced to the 8.87. So for the amount of water and pressure I'm going to it, that's like the smallest nozzle it can take. I am thinking about upgrading it one size to see how what the difference is. I just haven't had the money to do so right now. Probably go to the dealer and they'll never get a used one for real cheap and I'll have to get new. It'll probably be a 0.92 or something like that, a ring nozzle. So I have not tried to get that assembly off to install a paperboard because I had to take it to the dealer and have them get that cap off because it was on there really tight. So they did put NIC, so getting it off has been really easy. Running with two pumps. Seriously. My stand seems to be staying in pretty good too. It's right. I spread the legs out pretty far, so it does seem to shake, which is, you know, normal because, you know, the drive arm can get slipper forward. So this is Nelson's middle size gun. Say it's probably meant for around 100, maybe 175, 180 GPM to about, maybe about 500, 600. Somewhere around in there. Don't make these anymore though. None of the fast reverse guns are made by Nelson or any of the companies that I know of. They're just too problematic, have too many issues, and they hurt or kill too many people. When you're running near these guns, you have to treat them with respect because they're really dangerous. Especially when it ran from a big mag pump. So when they're running, you stay back and you don't mess with them. It's best to mess with them when they're off. Adjust them, check again. You need to adjust it again, turn it off. Sometimes I'll hold on to the drive arm while I'm adjusting it, but really the best thing is to mess with it when it's off. You don't want that gun coming back to hit you in the head or the arm or the back. That's gonna hurt. As you can see from this kicking back in reverse, this is really quick. That's because of the extra pressure. So I do need to take it in somewhere and have them inspect the brake mechanism because it seems to drag at certain points. You can find someone who can rebuild or maybe just fix it. Then I could probably adjust the brake a lot tighter on it so it doesn't reverse so fast. let it go one more time around, and then I'm shutting it off. Actually, I'm going to go out in the field.